Friends and fans, welcome back. Raptor here. It is part 17 for Climb Out Narodnaya. We're getting to the end here as we just have a few turns left in order to secure Oida, Nagasaki, and Kanoya. We're going to get started here with the Battle of Kumamoto. Keep in mind, we're about to wrap our clutches around Nagasaki in the next turn as soon as everything's replenished there. And, of course, we'll get continuously harassed here at Marugame and Nankoku. In fact, I believe the enemy will probably try to rush into us at the next turn, actually. Those choppers could try to go around, so we'll have to make sure they don't get by. In fact, I wonder if we could just try to attack them and, like, have them pester off or something like that. I don't know. All right. Anyway, oh, in fact, we can actually see some enemy transports by moving up. Delicious. Fantastic. So, ooh, look at this. Combat Assault Battalion, 3rd Marine Battalion, and a 32nd Armored. Ooh. And that's carrying, let's see, Abrams and Patton tanks. Oh, boy. Okay, we're going to have a real fight on our hands if and when they get to Kanoya. As soon as they can land, though I don't believe they can actually land unless they get to Nagasaki, so that's good for us. All right, so it looks like we've got most of the naval landing points. I hope the enemy doesn't cheat and just throw them up there because they can. So anyway, hopefully we can just get these helicopters. Yeah, we don't want any of these helicopters coming back to Nankoku until the start of our next turn, so we'll try to get some reinforcements in there if and when we can. In fact, we've got Flakstrelas, VDV 90. What do we have for tanks? Oh, nothing, even though it kind of shows it as a tank. I always get confused by that. It's because they have the, well, actually, we could refit this group, but there's not really much we're going to have to mess with there. So, all right, anyway, Battle of Kumamoto begins. Let us go ahead and start. By the way, we have our aircraft in here, Yak-141s and 38 strike squadrons as well. This battle is going to come down to time. I'm sure we're going to have to clear the map as soon as possible, and we must win this on this turn in order to stay on schedule. Not that we're behind schedule, but I have a schedule of trying to take all those positions when I told you that I was going to take them. So we're going to have to push through here mighty quick. This, by the way, will be our main force for attacking Kanoya. So anyway, here we go. So, by the way, we will have a ton of tanks this time as well. Of course, remember, our tank battalion is here. Where are they? Yes, the independent regiment. Yeah. All right. Let's get in there. We have Gulf as well, so that'll be a big plus for us. They have Delta, so we're going to have to crush these points ASAP. Unfortunately, they do have the anti-aircraft guns here, so we'll have to find those. They could be really a big pain in the ass for our aircraft, but hopefully our 141s are able to take down those A-10s as soon as they're spotted. Now, we're going to have to deal with Japanese peanut butter again. If you saw there in the listing, there's a plenty of Japanese tanks everywhere. So we're going to try to be limited on our point spending here. Let's go ahead and get some BTRs out. No. Well, one up here. And we'll need some additional tanks. The more the merrier, remember. And I don't know if we should bring out our elite tanks to start with. That might not be a good idea. But we're going to try to block all the positions we can with our T-72s. And additionally, we do have Strelas, yes, which are pretty poor, but at least it'll help in trying to shoot down enemy aircraft if and when they're spotted. We also have, of course, our 141s and such, so we're going to have to make sure we are well defended back at base. We may as well bring a FOB up here. These T-72s are going to be real gas hogs, so we're going to have to want to keep that somewhere near the road. And we'll have to, as soon as we can, push into Dmitri and Ivan, so we'll need more tanks. In fact, we should probably start with the greatest amount of tanks possible, otherwise it takes them quite a while to drive in. So we'll start with a big number. And, of course, we can't be overexposed with our tanks, so we're going to have to save up some points for our lovely 141s. So let's launch the battle. Now, you'll probably see enemy aircraft right away, A-10s, so we're going to have to make sure that we take those down ASAP, and it looks like Kagoshima was abandoned there for a second. Ivan is ready. We're going to call up our 141 just to make sure that A-10 doesn't come out, or those A-10s. They're a little behind us in morale points as well, so hopefully we get more points as we go along here. All right, T-72s can move up to block. And we've got a good group of six T-72As, making sure they don't get out of there. Ivan has been secured by them as well. I'm wondering what they're taking their time on. Seems like they should have captured that actually faster than that. Oh, here we are. Looks like we've got ourselves a couple of transports and other light vehicles. Tanks are coming into good play here. I'm sure their tanks aren't even going to be able to even engage us. So whatever we destroy here is going to be really good. Here comes the whole cluster. We may as well stop right there and start engaging. LAAD red eye is out. We wanted to make sure that died. 141 is stunned because of that red eye. No damage to it really though. But we can't call off the 141s. We got to make sure it's coming in all day every day. Have our T-72s move up. 141, you can break off. Have our next patrol come in. This is to defend those tanks against A-10s. I've learned my lesson from the last time. And I hope those are... Oh yes, that's infantry. Goodbye. Now we could call in a bomber. That's going to be a real good call. If we can get them... Apparently they're on the run now. That might be a command there. Oh, you bet your ass it is. Yep. Good. That looked like a French command for a second, but of course the Japanese get kind of the same looking thing. Alright, we're still getting points, though it's not fast enough. We gotta get this peanut butter out of the way so it doesn't attack Gregory. Once that's kind of cut through a little bit, A-10 Thunderbolt spotted, we're gonna engage that right now. Hopefully the 141 doesn't go into AA territory. Break off, break off. And you can RTB. Incoming missile. Right up the ass. Oh, he made it out, though. Yak 30. Oh, I totally forgot about the 38 bomber. That's okay. Another 141 is up, though. That's exactly what we need here. T-72As can get ready to roll into Ivan, then. We'll defend on the other side with those. We're traveling pretty light here. I'd like to have a lot more Marine support, but... T-72As are going to be out of ammunition soon enough. We need to capture some enemy supplies if and when spotted. Killing these tanks all day is fun, but we got to get moving. Keep this 141 out of harm's way. Now, I don't think the enemy has any AA. 141's burned through all of its fuel. Time to break off. I'm going to need to find enemy... supplies. Looks like there's a couple of transports moving through the woods. We got the steamroller advantage. Can't stop for fuel or anything yet, though. We got to keep moving. Those tanks can get around us. That's okay. We'll have to block that somehow. Maybe a chopper or two can do it. We'll get a couple of cheap choppers out to make sure Gregory stays safe against the Horde. Speaking of the Horde. Damn, they're blocking us at every damn turn with their numbers. All right, let's get into Ivan, make sure they don't spread to Nagasaki. You can bet your ass they're going to Fedor or one of those. Oh, bastards out. No way that thing was able to fire that fast, damn. It travels so slow, though. Thunderbolt's on his way out. We can kill that other one, I hope. Can't risk bringing in any more bombers, though. So it's time to bring up the big boys. We can actually try. We could have called in artillery and stuff, but we really got to hold with these tanks. T-72As, if we would have kept those numbers, would have been nearly unstoppable. I will risk the bomber, though, to destroy all that stuff. In Ivan, it looks like we may have found a command. There. Oh, no, that ain't it. Well, let's keep moving. Alright, Nagasaki looks like it hasn't been captured. Can't believe these T-72s are holding. That is beautiful. They're low on ammunition. They're basically just a roadblock. That's all they need to be. Command spotted over here. Wherever the hell it was. Bombs away, and the bomber made it out. Beautiful. Looks like the 141 parked in the garage of that house. Not necessarily, but... Alright, we're going to have to come in from the other way. Kregashima is probably crawling with AA. That's going to make tank support difficult with the A-10 that could come out at any moment. So we're going to hide back in the forest with these T-72s. And we'll have these other T-72s come up for support as well. I don't want to bring out the Strelas or anything yet, but damn, look at the peanut butter. Oh, you bastards. Now, of course, I don't want to use the T-55s. They're a little too specialized for this, and we don't really want to lose that many tanks, but we got to push very hard in order to get in there with the amount of AA they have and the amount of tanks they have. Looks like they've just captured Nagasaki, so they're going to call out air support from there now, if and when they spot tanks. Let's call out the Mi-24V to find him. We'll keep those T-72s right where they're at. Looks like the Thunderbolt's up. Bastard blocked us with the rest. Alright, we can call up our own command from Nagasaki, and we'll call in the rest of our own tanks from Nagasaki. Looks like they're fleeing. They know we're onto them. That means he's hiding right over in the corner. Oop, 141's being hit. That's gone. Damn. Look at all that AA. Too bad that CV's not dead. An unfortunate loss of equipment, though. That's why fighting with vehicles like that is difficult in this kind of situation. What we're going to do now is we're going to make sure the enemy doesn't get back around us. So we're going to call out units to Dimitri, make sure they don't get behind us. And I'm just going to call out individual infantry squads to these areas just to make sure they don't play that game. I'm not running out the clock due to the computer getting by with sneakiness. Now there's a lot of AT or a lot of AA that's moved up there, so we're gonna block on the right side now. And we're gonna come in from Ivan. Looks like that's an enemy AA right there. I'm gonna punish him. He's probably going. Oh, look at that! The IHawks are trying to go for the helicopters. I bet. Gonna go ahead and get that air out of there before the AA fires missile away. No, interesting. Command. Goodbye. Beautiful. Well, we're getting real lucky here. Though I don't like losing those tanks or aircraft, you really can't have a flawless victory in this game. There's no way. Nagasaki will be ours shortly. And then Ivan, we can actually capture Ivan and add a lot more pressure to the enemy. With 10 minutes left, we can build up a big force and plummet right down their throat. Another command killed. They're desperately trying to capture. That's exactly what they need to do. They're going to go for Ivan with the IHawk. Looks like they're maybe going for the helicopters. I'm just going to park our tanks right here in the intersection. More T-72s are coming up. Going to hide. Going to really want to call... I don't want to call out our air-to-air yet, but I do want to lure that that little bastard out. Looks like we're killing a lot of their AA, though. Nagasaki is ours. We can now start building up for our attack. And, you know, I'm actually going to call up a command. I'm going to call up an infantry command here. Time to start using our recon now. Anything air-to-air is probably going to get shot down, so we're going to call out a BRDM. Mi-24Vs will be in support on the left side. We've got Marines coming up at Dimitri. Something just tried to sneak behind us at Gregory there. Call out some more infantry. It looks like it's coming from this way. Oh, we don't have the points for that. Alright, we have half the battle has elapsed, and we've pretty much already captured most of the map. Looks like another Humvee, probably. That it is, and it's going to be going to Dimitri, so let's not let him sneak around us. We need to kill commands. Not for the points, but just to cut them off completely. Commands are fleeing. Beautiful. Alright, these T-72As are fantastic units. We may have to spend a turn just to replenish them in order to fight the Americans at the final destination. But all fighters here are very honorable. You know, everybody's fighting to their death. There's a lot at stake here. It's not an easy fight, that's for sure. And 8 minutes left, we should be able to do this. We'll have infantry try to strangle the enemy from both sides. Now, luckily, they'll have a lot of light tanks, but their light tanks will be easy to cut through with our T-72. Wow, look at that. They're just so desperate to cap with commands. We actually, geez, for them, the rate that they're sending out commands, we actually could cut through all of their commands and win just by that. All right, we've got more troops coming up via our new cap. We've got more points, so, of course, more troops are coming through. We've really got a nice cut into enemy territory now, and it looks like they're bringing up another command. You got to be kidding me. They are so desperate to cap. They need points. Alright, I'm going to drop the troops off here in just a second, and then we're going to kill them with the... This, by the way, has an engagement of 875, so we need to get quite a bit closer before we go for them. But the infantry can shoot all day, every day. Wow, we snuck in there without even being noticed. There we go. It would be nice to capture the cargo. Gonna have to call in a bomber on these or what? Come on, Marines, you're better than that. Fire your damn. There we go. Fire at the tanks! Fire at the tanks! Come on! There we go. Damn. Almost lost a squad because of that. All right, they can easily replenish. We're go. Okay, no. Yak, go somewhere else. All right, a lot of their AA moved up. That's fantastic. We're gonna have this MTLBV move up. All right, so we're gonna do a three-pronged attack with infantry for scouting. T-72s will come in at the end to clean up. There's no need for these B1s. Not enough numbers of those. Helicopters are great, but not now. More infantry then, if we can. Oh, we can only afford... Oh, okay. Alright, time to start unloading the infantry here and start getting into enemy territory. We've got 6 minutes. 6 minutes to make the final blow. They'll probably have more than one command, so keep an eye out for it for me, will you? Thanks. Alright, so they're going to send out commands. We do have one at Oida just in case. A group to spot for any trickiness. More troops are coming in from the right. Marines are moving up now. We'll have these Marines get a little bit closer, see what we can do at a close range. T-72As will be in support on all fronts. Helicopters more towards the north. Whew. All right, it's coming down to this time. We can't have a draw. We must have a total victory here. We got to knock them off. It's got to be it. Factoria would have been great if we were in a defensive position. Grads. Actually, we could probably call in a ton of Ergens and just try to obliterate that Kagoshima. We may as well give that a try. Alright, these Marines will be able to unload and go over the hill. Alright, so if we get right into the forest, we should be able to cover this entire area. That would be fantastic. T-72As can move up. We don't really have any AA other than our aircraft. That could be a command right there, I'm sure it is. Jeez, again. Oh, it's an Avenger. That'll be a nice kill. Beautiful. Alright, time to move in. T-72As are moving on up. Alright, Ergens are ready. Split these guys up. Don't want to turn off the weapons, actually. Alright, let's fire away. One. 2 and 3. And we'll let our Marines sit right at the edge, see if, actually, these guys can hop right into town. And after the barrage, it'll be an open door. Really cool to see those things shoot. Oh, so pretty. Beautiful. What a beautiful sky. Alright, so here comes the rockets. This should stun and or kill any transports or light units here. Don't be surprised if you see a bunch of 10s. Or nothing at all. Could go either way. Okay, well, whatever was there, it's stunned to hell now. MTLBVs are ready to roll. Once Kagoshima has been taken, this actually might be the command here, this might actually be the end. Nope, not quite yet. But anyway, once we've got this area, if we haven't yet captured it, we'll just call out a massive amount of helicopters and try to find that last command wherever it may have gone. I'm sure it's around here somewhere, if there is one. Good capture on those cargo trucks, too. That'll be a real big benefit towards the end. Captured a FOB. T-72As are thirsty. With 2 minutes left, we were able to crack the nut. Is that the end of the battle? Yes, it is. Wow. Fantastic. All right, so we did take some losses there. VDV Cape from a previous battle, I believe. UAZ. Actually, those aren't right for losses here. Hold on, let me... I always look at that for losses, but... Anyway, we did lose some... well, you saw what we lost. Just a few tanks and, unfortunately, a 141. So that's it for that battle. I'm glad we did that. It's a total victory. So an elimination of the anti-air... Craft company is out of the way. That is awesome. The 1st Central Tank Regiment and, of course, Special Forces are gone, just leaving the Strike Squadron, which we pretty much took down a lot of that. Just 1 and 3. Too bad we couldn't kill more. Well, the enemy flees then to somewhere where we don't really mind. It's all good there. You go right over there. We're going right past you. Though they could add reinforcements at the end. Naval Sector Romeo doesn't look like they're going to want to bro down from there. They actually might even go around us. But anyway, we can, of course, always add some more reinforcements to Nankoku with our naval reinforcement call-out. So let's go ahead and end the turn, and we'll see what happens. Of course, the helicopters probably just fly by us. Shocking. And at least we didn't get a lot of helicopters. Oh, never mind. There's everything they've got. Just landed at Nankoku. Now we did... Oh, damn. We won't get those reinforcements because it's in jeopardy. Independent Naval Regiment has... Ooh, a ton of ships, though. But unfortunately, they have a lot of the land as well. We have 32 Igla with us. That's actually pretty promising. Central Engineers. Let's see if we can... Of course, we can't call in any reinforcements. Might be actually worth fighting this battle. Though I'd like to retreat. All of the AA and VDV we have would be extremely useful here. They have artillery, they have central... they have a lot of aircraft. Apache, Cobra, OH-58s. Interesting. Well, what should we do? If we fight them, we could definitely put a lot of hurt on them. And of course, we can't get any sort of reinforcements, which is unfortunate. I'd really like some reinforcements. Looks like they want to finally fight us at Naval Sector Romeo, though. All right. Well, let's go ahead and get started then. I think let's do another battle. So we'll bro down then at Naval Sector, or rather Nankoku. Really sucks that we captured it. All that took all that time to cap, and now we got to defend. Though I'm hoping the enemy, yeah, they probably won't bring in ships. Anyway, let's do it. What do they got for ships, by the way? Nothing. Absolutely nothing. so we can actually bombard the hell out of them from the sea. So we may as well do that, and or otherwise have a draw. And of course, doing that will delay them from capturing this area, and we can bring in some reinforcements and really punish them. Right, so let's fill up our reinforcement sectors. Fedor here has a real nice... oh, look at that. Isn't that awesome? Look at how many infantry we can call out for air-to-air. It's fantastic. Not to mention every one of these transports is basically a nice AA unit as well. Alright, we have Marugame as well. Yeah, that's really what you want for infantry callouts. 30 times 32. Fantastic. We can actually get some Flakstrela too, but we're going to spend it on the infantry first. Alright, next we can call out some naval ships. Of course, we're going to want a few of these big boys. Our Gaijin here can stay back. That's what I call that. Alright, now of course they're not going to have Naval Sector Quebec, but we could probably bring over a command there. Speaking of commands, we're going to need a couple of them. We'll then put one here. And one here. Alright, now, we've got less morale than them, but that's good. That means we have more morale of theirs to bring down. Look at it that way. A lot of the helicopters will probably come from EU as well, but we can get them at Dimitri, and we'll shoot down a lot of those helicopters with the nunchucks. Hiya, here we go. Alright, everybody should be deployed. These Zekarets should hide as soon as possible, wherever they can go. Let's get our nunchucks to rock and roll. They can go right up between Dimitri. Looks like we've spotted some helicopters as well. Looks like rocket artillery is already insta-ack art. Apparently they've seen these units, even though we haven't seen them yet. They're already firing rockets because they know where we are, apparently. Okay, we lost an Igla group there, unfortunately. They're about to lose much more once we come up behind them. QEs are coming across. We'll see how far they get. Yeah, they're definitely desperate to attack. Oh, so sad. So sad for you. Yes, flee, my children, flee. Quiet, you. Cobras are running. What's this? Are these cobras? Just park there, please. No. I didn't mean cobras. Oh, look at this. Rockets again. Ooh, and a command. Hello, beautiful. Blackhawks again. Iglas are just overworked with all their shooting down. Damn. Beautiful. Good kills on all fronts. Can't let those rockets fire again, though. Time for VDV. They're in Ryan Seacrest as well, which is fantastic. Oh, hello, Apaches. Huh, Apaches don't want to play, it seems. We'll keep our nunchucks on the move. Those rockets are dead. They killed Igla again, but that's okay. Bastards. Alright, you know what? Now you're getting it. Alright, they're bringing up a... UH-1 there. Ultra High Frequency starring Weird Al will return after these messages. Let's bring our Zekrits right in town. Actually, let's attack their little plot pod. I'm so glad we didn't retreat because the computer's ignorance. Look at the Apaches are just afraid. It's like that monster from Starship Troopers. It's more afraid of us than we are of it. We do have Shikis coming in now. That's something I didn't anticipate. Though they're only 10-point tanks, so we actually might be able to bro down with those. Not even tanks, they're just transports. The Apaches are getting a little curious. That's going to be the death of the Apaches. They're going to get stunned, and then they're going to get shot down by Igles. So long as we keep them still. Damn, Ural trucks are going to get hit. Oh, look at the Kiwas. Sneaking up over the hill. Pay no attention to those Apache, or the other ones, just go for that. Well, we've got transports coming now. Troop transports, so we'll have to pay more attention to them. Boom, baby! Fuck yo, daddy! Motherfucker! That's the best goddamn group ever. There's got to be a class higher than Elite. There's got to be just Elite. L-E-E-T. Because those guys right there, holy crap. Those guys just killed everybody. Damn. Door is open, baby. Alright. Sanshiki, you're being mean. Wow. Just amazing what those Igles just did. Wonder if we can shoot that down. Just run back in. It's alright if we lose, and we've got plenty, but the attack's gotta continue. Gonna have these Igla guys move up. Everything's gotta move up now. Time to put a little, what the hell is this? Oh god, they got hover boots again! Damn it! There's only one way to defend against hover boots. Alright, we're gonna have our Igles move up here. Hover boots are hilarious, their troops are just not animating that they're retreating. We're gonna have to call in some, rocket vehicles. I'm glad we didn't call out Strelas here, they would have just been immediately murdered. Maybe we can find a helicopter command here. These guys right here, this one man. Formanov, yeah, more like one man army of four. That guy right there just killed four Apache helicopters with one missile, fended off a Huey attack, and now he's going back to the woods because he forgot his smokes. Epic badass. That man is a hero of the Broviet Union. Oop, gun tanks here. Those tanks scare me, actually. In this situation. Oop, I didn't want the Igla to come up. Oh, of course. I killed four Hueys with an Igla, and now I think that they're Superman, but they're not. Alright, we've targeted the gun tank. Let's have a bro down. Gun tanks might win this one, but... we got our 40-man squads ready to move up. We're blocking the bridge with our nunchucks. Amazing. Kiryuka Hawk there. Kiryu Hawk, goodbye. I care for you not. M42 AAG is an anti-aircraft gun. So you gotta be on the lookout for that. One gun tank is down. These ships aren't able to go up the river again, remember, since the bridge is in the way. Pesky bridges. Nash bridges. Wow. Oh, enemy retreated, didn't they? Total victory, what? With one squad, look at what they lost. No way. I cannot believe that. Six OH-58s, four Cobras, four Apaches. That general better shoot himself. That is... Japan wants to be communist, bro. Well done, comrade. You've crashed helicopter force of American dog. Thank you, Putin. Yes. Fuck planes. Alright, so, wow. Look at that. Everything is on fire. Wow. Damn. I kind of want to... Oh, I can't retreat from that. I was going to say, I kind of want to go back up to... Oh, no, Quebec's there. Son of a... Why? Why is it theirs? I was just up there. They had a helicopter move in. Oh, that's really dumb. Anyway, Naval Sector Romeo, do you think we'll be able to fight them? Of course. We'll call up, let's see. Well, we'll do those moves next. So anyway, until next time, this is Raptor reminding you to keep your password and pimp hand strong. I'll see you guys. Bye.